Hi, welcome back to Meta Rules TV, where the underground meets the playground. I'm Jeff Rappaport.
Is it on?
What are you, Bobby Brady?
And I'm Jason Robinson.
From
Wrath Of Typhon, your PA metal.
Right, the first question I have for you is, I couldn't help but notice your t-shirt.
Oh yes, the most metal shirt of them all there. Some Britney Spears, you know, you nearly mosh to that.
Yes.
You really smash a kid into a wall with that music. Yes.
Spears are pretty metal,
you know, so, yes.
They're very Norwegian and Viking.
So. Right.
A lot of weird men kind of look at my shirt funny, like they want to make out with it, and that's the other thing I get sometimes, especially at Comic Cons. I go to the Philly Con sometimes, and I wore the shirt last year, and then people are like, making really funny gestures about
it. Right, a guy probably wants to just come over and kiss your belly.
Yeah.
Did he start doing that ever?
Her belly's in the same spot.
And then one guy's like, I really want to make out with your shirt. And I'm like,
I'm like, all right, nobody's around.
Nobody's around. Yeah. So
no one's looking, so take a bite. Go on in.
The water's fine.
Yeah.
Woo!
Now, you look like you're a pretty clean guy, yeah. So, wondering what kind of brand of soap you use.
You're going to laugh at this. Twilight Woods, that stuff you get at Bath.
My roommate uses that.
Yeah.
Bath and Body Works.
Yeah. Bath and Body Works, I really can. And my lady wife, she got me hooked on the smells in there. I do like smells, you know.
Right.
Smell of blood, not just actually nice smells, you know, so. I really like
the smell of blood. Has its place, but
yeah.
Not when you're
washing it on my body like Sam Hain. No.
You know they have a line for men as well.
Yes, that's what it is.
Oh, the Twilight Woods
for
men.
It's Twilight for men body wash.
Oh.
Now we're really talking men.
Does that sound like a man soap, Twilight Woods?
It smells good though. My old roommate, the guy that helped me.
Yeah, of course that movie came out, so it doesn't really sound.
I feel like there's a guy in my gym that I call Twilight because he looks like one of the guys from Twilight. He does. Every time I see him, I'm like, it's like a joke for myself because nobody else knows about it. I go to the gym by myself, so I'm just like, like I'm saying in my head, like, there's Twilight, there he is, and I'm like, this is really weird. Like, no one's even enjoying this because no one's sharing this. I'm like, there's Twilight again. I don't want to go up to him one day and say, hey, Twilight, and see if he understands what's going on.
Right, shut up, man. As far as I know, they're unaffiliated. The body wash in the movie.
Yeah, they're totally
connection as far as
unaffiliated. Yeah.
Interesting. Now. You like girly soap? Do you like grocery shopping?
Oh, yeah. So, like, the grocery... Well, you gotta eat.
Yeah.
You know? Well, obviously, you gotta eat.
Yeah.
You know?
And I do.
Unless you want to, like, to really want to eat roadkill or something. But
right, but you like your wife go, or do you like to go? And
I go with her, of course, you know? I mean, you do.
Make sure she gets it.
Gotta make sure... Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. Blueberry, Frankenberry, Cap'n Crunch, you know? Stuff like that, yeah.
Exactly.
All the great cereals and stuff like that.
Stock up on that.
Yeah.
What do you think is the...
Pour some whiskey in your cereal? No, I don't do that. Not milk.
I wouldn't like that, yeah.
Nah, I don't think
I mean, I like... There's nothing wrong with whiskey.
Time and a place?
Yeah.
That's not it.
Doesn't seem like the right combination.
Oh, man. Cap'n Crunch. No, I never
That's like
before.
The theme of this interview so far. Time and a place.
Yes. Everything is time and place. Speaking of that, what would be the breaker for you in a friendship? Like, what could be a friendship breaker for you?
Man, who are you asking?
Like,
me
going
now
to a concert
or me?
Without
your
friend?
Me... Yeah.
What was that?
Going to a concert without your friend? Could be.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Dan, that might be a big one, depending on the show, you know. Ooh. Yeah. A friend break.
I got paid to go, too. I don't know if I mentioned.
Yeah. He's going to kill you.
I wrote a column for Blabbermouth, and they paid me $300 to do it. Cool. Yeah.
Did they really?
No. I did get a bunch of stuff I'm going to sell on eBay, though.
That'd be...
I actually did get paid in a way to go.
A breaker 1-9. If it's a serious question, if one of my friends would hit a woman or my chick, or I kind of would break it off for me because I have a thing about that. That's very noble. But I'm more easygoing now. So
right.
It's like if you would ask me that like 15 years ago, I said there's a lot of things. But a lot of things 15 years ago, I'm like, man, I'm easygoing now. So
right.
I think the big one is like. Men, don't hit your women. It's bad stuff. I don't like it. I'll bite your throat out and howl at you at the same time. No, I'm just joking. I'm making myself really nuts here. Am I allowed to yell at someone? No.
But you should...
I'm pointing at somebody.
You should hit people that hit girls.
Yes, exactly.
I agree with that.
Don't do
you
that.
You should hit women.
That's stupid.
Unless they, like, burn your toast. Then you have a good reason for it.
Toast.
Yeah.
Or, like, forget to leave the toilet seat.
If they put it down like to go to the bathroom and you're like I like it up and then you know they might deserve a sock or two. You know, just
my roommate,
a sock for their feet.
Yeah.
My roommate
sock
keeps,
in the eye.
My current roommate keeps unplugging my boombox in the bathroom. I might smack her soon for that. So, Dio agrees completely.
What TV shows or movies bring tears to your eyes? What do you watch that just he gets you all emotional?
Dexter.
And up?
Dexter actually does it.
Makes you cry? Dexter.
At the very end of the first season, when, not to be a spoiler, but most of you should have seen season one by
now. I just saw it, because I just got
But you know what I'm talking about?
I've
the
seen
end?
The first season, yeah.
At the end of the brothers?
What he had to do, yeah.
That kind of made me tear up a little bit. Because
now
you know?
He, like...
And Spartacus. I just saw the new... I'm not a spoiler alert, but what happens at the end of the newest Spartacus also made me tear up. So, it's when something very noble happens, and it's very big on a big scale, and he's taking it all to the weight of the world. That's the kind of thing.
That's what makes you cry?
Yeah. Well, not cry, but swell up.
Right, right.
Yeah. Get a little teary.
I just watched...
If I'm into a character and he gets offed, then I get pissed off.
Yeah, because I just rewatched Oz, the entire show, and the episode where Cyril...
It's the electric chair.
Not only when they finally do it, but the one where it's like the whole build up and at the last minute, spoiler, the governor calls. That one kind of choked me up. When it was originally aired and now, which is probably like 10 years apart almost. So.
Tears are falling.
Yeah.
I know
tears
are falling.
Yes.
That was a build up. what's your bad habit that you have that you know you have it and you know it annoys people? But you just can't. You can't control it. You just have to. People just have to deal with it.
Shit. Ah. Sometimes I will not make. Well, no, that's a good one. That's probably a couple there. I could be very rambunctious and annoying sometimes. Not even annoy myself sometimes. I'll say.
You have a lot of energy.
Yeah, a lot of energy. I do have a lot. That doesn't really bother people. But sometimes I could be overbearing, and they won't say it to my face. But I know it's like. Shut up.
Yeah.
Because sometimes I'll say shut up to myself, you know. Or I'll say stuff that don't make sense, or I'll stutter sometimes. And sometimes you get nervous, you start stuttering. I hate that. But people are like, well, boys, what are you saying? Speak up. And then I get more frustrated when you explain something. Stuff like that, you know. I really... Nothing too wonderful. Nothing too crazy. But that sometimes I can be overbearing. Because sometimes I can't stand myself, you know.
Okay.
But other than that, I'm more fun. I'm fun. Fun sometimes. All the time.
Just do fun now, yeah.
Fun every time. All the time. I'm in fun right now.
Yeah.
It's awesome.
Yeah.
That's the
good
goal.
Time.
That's the goal.
How do you know when you've reached your limit?
Of. Limit of.
That's up to
bonus.
Your own interpretation.
Yeah. I don't know. When I'm tired.
Yeah.
when I'm tired and want to go to sleep, you know.
That's a good answer.
Yeah, that's about it, because, you know, some days I'm on fire, and the other days I'm watered down, you know. Those days I'm like, I don't want to deal with anything, just go to sleep. But I have an energy level like I wouldn't believe for my age, so people are like, what are you on? It's like, just breathe in the air, something in the air.
It's nice, it's nature, it's the soap.
Nature does it for you!
It's twilight.
It's the soap!
Twilight forest.
Twilight, the sparkle is!
Why don't you all breathe in some air?
Did I do anything for you?
No.
I think I just bowled like mold spores or something.
Nah, but I like to have fun, yeah. You know. You try to be easy going, but there's days you get like a crotchety. I get crotchety like anybody else, you know. I'm not gonna be annoying.
What do you consider is bad taste? You know, people have like a limit. What do you
liver?
Think? Yeah.
that tastes bad to me. Oh, bad tasting. Nickelback, that's bad taste.
Yeah.
Creed, that's bad taste. I don't care. Across the board, that's bad. Like, I would listen to Britney Spears before Creed or Nickelback or whatever else. Any of that cookie cardboard cutout formula.
Yeah.
I guess. And I'm sorry about offending Nickelback fans or Hellstorm fans, but if you would switch Chad Kroeger and Lizzie Hale, it would be like, oh, wait. Chad Kroeger's in Hellstorm, but it still sounds like Nickelback, you know? Or, now Nickelback sounds like Hellstorm. Hellstorm's lucky because they have an awesome female, and she lives in my neck of the woods in Red Lion, PA, so I'm allowed to do this.
Have you run into her at all?
No, not in a long time.
I'd like to run into her.
I ran into the drummer, and he's like, you know, he's all right, you know, whatever. But, like, I think, you know, fame, Hollywood got to that band, and now they're following the Hollywood chart. I'm sorry, I'm saying that like it is, and that's how it's what about what it's all about. But I was hoping she would be another Lita Ford type, or, you know, Pat Benatar with the rebelliousness, and it looks like it's, like, more Hollywood stuff.
More commercial.
More commercial.
Yeah.
Sing a song.
Look at my face in the mirror. It's pretty.
Is that the actual lyrics?
No, but notice a lot of the songs are like it.
That should be a song.
Yeah, like, look at my butt, it's awesome. You know, punch me in the face, it's great. Yeah. You know, whatever.
I thought we didn't hit women. Wait.
But
yeah,
no,
yeah.
But
yeah, you're mixing it all up.
To give credit due, she does have amazing voice though. That's given. But I just wish they would write to what they're supposed to write. Probably get hanged for that when I go back home. But
she's probably saying, "I don't see your name in my tattoo." So
I don't see you. I don't see you touring big shows.
That's a lyric to one of her songs.
I don't see you playing.
How do you know that?
You haven't heard any Hailstorm? You're on the radio a lot, dude.
No, I mean, it is catchy, but it's not my catchy. You know what I mean?
I'm impressed that you don't listen to the radio.
I do have the first album, but it's just.
Like, I've heard that done, but better. Yeah. Like, kind of is my fault.
Like Maria Brinkman, this moment, I think, is better on a vocal scale and writing, musically, you know?
Also, their new album has a lot of naked chicks on it, yeah. So that's kind of.
Like, you know, she kind of sounds like Pat Benatar when she lets out.
And blondes are hotter, anyways, too.
And when she lets out her singing side, especially on the first album, that's what it's all about. I think you got some of that rebelliousness from the old time mixed with the new time. I think that's what just happened with Hailstorm.
Yeah.
Get away from that record stuff and write your. Just go from the. Be solid, be from the organic, and just do your thing, you know? Do what got you there, but don't.
Say it with your chest.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Boom! Not what they want you to. I know they're telling that. Just write like this, write like that, because I know that's what they do when Bruce Dickinson did solo stuff.
Right.
They wanted them to sound like Aerosmith. I mean, seriously, I read that in an article.
In the Tattoo Millionaire?
Yeah, it made me want to die when they said this. Like, that's Bruce Dickinson, not Steven Tyler. You got Steven Tyler for that, you know? It's that kind of thing.
But he did All the Young Dudes.
Yeah.
All right. On that note, we got to take a quick break.
Sure.
And we'll be right back.